We have shown from our record that money and power, or who you are, will not stop us from a criminal investigation or prosecuting a case. And what was revealed through this investigation was a man who had spent decades preying on women that he drugged and sexually assaulted, and a man who had evaded this moment here today for far too long. He used his celebrity, he used his wealth, he used his network of supporters to help him conceal his crimes. And now we really know today who was behind that act, who the real Bill Cosby was. And a jury has spoken with one voice in a court of law and found the defendant guilty of drugging and sexually assaulting Andrea Constan in his Elkins Park home. Now, there's a number of people up here, and I'm going to try to address as many of this as I can. But before you today is just a part of the team that worked tirelessly to get us to this point. And the most important person in this is Andrea Constan. There you are. 14 years later, it may be easy to forget that she was that first courageous person that stood up in public to go to the authorities and say that Bill Cosby drugged and sexually assaulted her. Her courage, her resilience in the face of horrible and unfounded attacks upon her and her family has been so inspiring to all of us. We thank her. We thank her family. We thank her mother, Gianna, for trusting us through this process of prosecuting her attacker. And standing next to her there is Dolores Triani, who with B.B. Kivitz were the ones that were asking the questions in that deposition that Judge Rubino was referring to that got us to the point where we were able to reopen this case and seek justice. And standing with her through this whole process has been a lot of other courageous women who are willing to stand up and tell their stories about being drugged and sexually assaulted or raped. 19 were willing to stand up with us in this prosecution, take the witness stand, and we are humbled by the courage all of them showed. And we can't help but applaud and celebrate the courage of the five witnesses that had a chance to face Bill Cosby in this case, to tell the jury, to tell all of you what he did to them. So Heidi Thomas, Shalon Lasha, Janice Dickerson, Janice Baker Kinney, and Lieselot Lublin. We public here thank all of them. I called each of them after the verdict. Was not able to talk to all of them, but they know what they've done, and they know what their courage helped all of us do. So supporting all of these women have been the victim advocates, the victims groups, the women's groups, the anti-rape groups, and so many others. And each of these groups play such an important role in supporting these women and helping them to heal from the ordeal that they have been put through. Those are the people we all owe a debt of gratitude to today for their strength, for their resilience through this entire process, as well as every day, because they stand with us, they work with the victims, and they make a difference in their lives. I'm very grateful to stand here before you with this team, and again, it's not all of our team who worked to see that justice was done, but we had to overcome many legal hurdles that were thrown at us by various defense lawyers who have been on this case for the past 28 months. And this time, from the lawyers of four different law firms, And each step of the way, we fought for the opportunity for the victims to be heard, the opportunity to get this case to a jury, an opportunity to be standing before all of you after hearing the defendant had been convicted of three counts of aggravated indecent assault. This team has been incredible. I can't say enough about the prosecutors, the detectives, dedicated staff who, despite everything that was thrown at us, at them, stayed the course, eye on the ball, and worked to get us here today. And I'm so incredibly proud of these talented people. They're committed always to do the right thing for the right reasons. And I'm going to have to start with, I think I heard him referred to recently as just thunder and lightning. So Mr. Ryan here on my left, he heads our family protection unit. And, you know, he's prosecuted a lot of cases, sexual assaults, rapes, and those have been drugged in sexual assault cases. He's been with our office 6 years and just is one of the best. You saw some of that talent coming across throughout this trial. And I got reports on how I looked as I was watching what they did. And it's the other thing I enjoy doing is coaching. And, you know, you get to these points where you work with kids, you work with young adults, and you get to that point where you put them out on the field or onto the court, and there's not much you can do at that point other than watch. And I could not have been more proud of what they did throughout this whole thing, and some of the cross-examination that that you all got to see, and some of the quick-witted remarks were something. I think even caused the jurors to laugh when testimony was being read or coming back on things, and where they had the ability here at his closing, and Kristen here. So we wouldn't be here if not for her. And I say that because when we came back to look at this case, Risa Vetri Furman, and I should refer to her as Judge Furman now, asked Kristen and some of our team to go to Toronto to meet with Andrea. And that was a difficult task. And when Kristen came back, she was adamant about what we should do. And we moved forward. And it was the right thing to do. And she has stuck through this the whole way. And she had an opportunity, which was kind of a bad day for me, when she had a great opportunity for her and her family to go to an excellent law firm, Stradley Ronan. And we talked a lot, and Kristen did not want to leave this and not see it to the end. And we talked to Bill Sasso, the chairman of the firm, who we all owe a debt of gratitude to for allowing her to stay on with us and stay with us through this case. And you have seen the results of that. She, like Mr. Ryan here, has prosecuted so many sexual assaults, domestic violence cases, and she's always stood up for victims and has continued to do this. And I couldn't have found two better partners through this, two better people, two better prosecutors to walk this journey with. Their commitment to doing the right thing has been extraordinary.